Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Charlene Israel.
And I'm Ephraim Graham. A new round of threats from North Korea, and they're upping the ante today, vowing to restart a nuclear reactor that can make the most common fuel for nuclear weapons.
The fear of a war with North Korea continues to grow, with the regime's mounting threats against the U.S. and South Korea. The latest move in the nuclear standoff, leader Kim Jong-un says he will restart a dormant reactor in his main nuclear facility, one that has the ability to produce material for one atomic bomb per year. The reactor was shut down in 2007 as part of international nuclear disarmament talks. This marks the first time North Korea admitted the reactor would be used to make nuclear weapons. When it was first unveiled, the North insisted it was to generate electricity. Even with this latest round of threats, the White House says there's no evidence Kim Jong-un will actually act.
Despite the harsh rhetoric we're hearing from Pyongyang, we are not seeing changes to the North Korean military posture, such as large-scale mobilizations and positioning of forces.
Meanwhile, the Washington Free Beacon reports China has begun activating troops near the Korean Peninsula. China is obligated to defend North Korea under a treaty between the two countries, and the U.S. is responding to North Korea's threats with a show of force, sending stealth B-2 bombers, F-22 fighters, and now a U.S. Navy destroyer to the region.
And we believe this has reduced the chance of miscalculation and provocation.
North Korea claims it's working towards nuclear-tipped missiles that can reach the United States. It's not believed to currently have the technology, but U.S. military bases in the region would be within range of a North Korean strike.
The Pentagon says while it is taking North Korea's threat seriously, it's been careful not to overreact and escalate the conflict into war.
Lawmakers in Connecticut have reached a deal on tough new gun laws. The measures include registration requirements for existing magazines that carry 10 or more bullets, a statewide dangerous weapon offender registry, and universal background checks for all firearms sales. The bill also addresses mental health and school security measures. The measure is the state's response to the Sandy Hook Elementary School massacre last December.
Stockton, California is officially bankrupt. A federal judge ruled Monday the city can't pay its bills and has no other options. Stockton is the most populated city in America ever to declare bankruptcy. A combination of plummeting property values, a decrease in sales and tax revenues, and generous benefits for city employees contributed to the crisis. City officials will now begin negotiating with the city's creditors to make smaller payments on the millions they're owed. Lawyers for the creditors insist the city has not tried hard enough to find the money.
The battle over gay marriage heats up again in Rhode Island this week. It's the last state in New England to hold out for traditional marriage, and so gay activists have targeted. Already, the Rhode Island House has passed a gay marriage measure, and the governor supports it. That leaves the matter up to the state Senate.
Now to talk about what's happening in Rhode Island is Chris Plant, regional coordinator for the National Organization for Marriage. Chris, how close are gay rights supporters to getting what they want in Rhode Island?
Marriage hangs on a knife's edge in Rhode Island. There are two senators who sit on the Judiciary Committee who have professed their support of traditional marriage, yet have not committed to voting no in committee. And that is going to be a problem for us potentially.
Tell us about the opposition. I understand there was a 12-hour hearing last week where hundreds, including many traditional marriage supporters, testified.
Absolutely. Opposition to redefining marriage continues to grow in Rhode Island as things get more and more heated. Many of those, if not most of those folks out at the State House 2 weeks ago were supporters of traditional marriage who had lined the halls for hours to testify, who rallied in the rotunda of the State House singing and praying. So we're confident in the popular opposition to redefining marriage. However, as many of your viewers know, it comes down to politics.
Well, Chris, we know you've mentioned to us in the past that a group of Hispanic and Black pastors has gotten on board. How did those pastors get involved, and what kind of a difference are they making?
Our Hispanic and Black brothers and sisters are making a huge difference. They, over the last couple of years, they've coalesced into what is now the Faith Alliance. So they have a formal organization. They are able to bring out hundreds, sometimes thousands of folks to the State House. They submitted another 7,000, almost 8,000 signatures in this debate opposing the redefinition of marriage. If you've seen, even on the national scale, last week in Washington, D.C., at the first March for Marriage, a huge proportion of that population, or the marchers, were Hispanic. And so here in Rhode Island, we're seeing the same thing.
What's at stake here? Why are gay activists targeting Rhode Island?
Well, you know, they'll tell you that Rhode Island is the last New England state. They're really targeting Rhode Island because this is really their last chance. They have a governor who is supportive, a speaker of the House who is supportive, both of whom will have to face re-election. The governor is hugely unpopular, and any other governor coming in most likely will oppose redefining marriage. And so they're giving it this last shot. Our opposition needs wins. They still have to remember, and our viewers need to remember, that 32 states have voted as states to protect marriage as one man and one woman, and another 8 do it in their state statutes. That's fully 40 out of our 50 states. So this is not there. You know, this is not some sense of inevitability. Our opponents are looking for a win, and Rhode Island seems at least poised, as I said, on a knife's edge to potentially go that way.
Real quickly, what is your group doing, and what can our viewers do at this time to protect traditional marriage there?
Well, we continue to raise up our grassroots army here. There are two senators, Senator Connolly from East Providence and Senator Raptakis from Coventry. They both sit on the Judiciary Committee here in Rhode Island. They both have said that they believe marriage is between one man and one woman. What they have not done is committing to voting no in committee. And so we need people to be calling both of those senators, and their information can be found on our website, NOMRI, that's NOMRI.org. And people need to call. Your viewers who are from out of state need to be praying, need to be calling their friends and family here in Rhode Island, because Senators Raptakis and Senator Connolly really hold this in their hands. And if they fail to vote, or they choose to vote yes for some reason in committee, then marriage will go to the floor debate in Rhode Island, in the Rhode Island Senate, and it'll be a much harder fight for us.
All right. Chris Plant with the National Organization for Marriage, thank you for your time.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
New Jersey lawmakers are one step closer to banning children from receiving reparative therapy for homosexuality. Some say so-called conversion therapy has sparked a culture war between those who believe people are born gay and those who believe it's a learned behavior. The New Jersey bill would outlaw the practice for people younger than 18. It now heads for a full Senate vote after passing in committee. California legislators passed a similar ban last year, but an appeals court ruled it violates the First Amendment.
A law legalizing marijuana in Rhode Island kicked in Monday. Under the law, there is no longer the penalty of jail time for anyone caught with small amounts of pot. Instead, they'll face a $150 fine. The issue has many divided. Critics worry the law will lead to more people smoking pot.
We don't even have, you know, drunk driving soda. We don't even have that. I mean, we're still losing up to 25 people every year in our state, you know, to drunk driving, alcohol-related crashes.
Supporters of the measure say those who use marijuana are not going to do it regardless if it's legal, are going to do it rather regardless if it's legal or not. Rhode Island is also preparing to open its first medical marijuana dispensaries. It is now one of 13 states to decriminalize marijuana.
A series of attacks on churches over Easter weekend. Thieves robbed churches in Shelby Township, Michigan, and Camden, New Jersey. In Shelby, they broke into a Catholic church after Easter services and made off with $40,000 in cash. In Camden, a Baptist church had its stained glass windows broken and electronic equipment stolen on Good Friday. Meanwhile, in Rock Island, Illinois, parishioners at Sacred Heart Church say a man walked up to a 100-year-old statue of Jesus, pushed it over, and walked away. The statue depicting the Savior with outstretched arms was damaged. No one was close enough to get a good look at the culprit.
The Bible drama on the History Channel got a big boost from viewers for its series finale on Easter Sunday. Deadline.com reports 11.7 million viewers tuned in. That is up 14% from the previous episode. The final installment included the crucifixion and resurrection of Jesus. The success of this series makes the History Channel the top cable network for the month of March.
Coming up, this may look like the scene of a terrorist attack. Find out how it's helping to prepare emergency workers for any situation.
Today we're on a field trip to discover what inflation is doing to our paper money. In this hand is a $20 bill, and in this hand is a $20 US gold coin. They used to have the same buying power, but how much can they buy today? In this first basket is what my $20 bill buys: milk, bread, peanut butter, and jelly. And here's what one $20 gold coin will buy: 6 baskets full, worth nearly $2,000, almost 100 times more food, simply by owning gold dollars instead of paper dollars. History shows that the gold coins have been the best way to beat the rising cost of living. So, class, the moral is that unless you want to live on peanut butter and jelly sandwiches in the future, you should turn some paper dollars into gold coins now. How and why is explained in a new book, The Great Debasement. Call the number below for a totally free copy. And that's the simple truth.
If an emergency happened right now, you can have help at the push of a button with Medical Alert.
Remember when I took that fall, Mary?
Oh, yes, that was terrible.
Yes, it was.
Help!
And I thought, what if you hadn't been there? I ordered my Medical Alert the next day.
I can't describe how safe I feel now with my Medical Alert. You didn't know I was wearing it, did you?
Medical Alert is easy to install, waterproof, and covers you inside your home and out.
It helps me feel safe from fires, break-ins.
And of course, a Medical Alert. And if you don't have a home phone, don't worry. They have that covered.
There's always help at the push of a button. Don't wait till you need it.
Get Medical Alert for less than a dollar a day. There are no long-term contracts. Order now and get your second button free. Call for your free brochure.
For your free Medical Alert system with second button free, call 800-575-8507.
From CBN.
Broken Eardrum is playing at the Civic tonight.
And you'll just have to miss it.
This is so incredibly unfair.
A special story of love and sacrifice.
Joy, Mom comes up with something.
Christopher Quantum, you and I are going to discuss your attitude right this minute.
Superbook.
No.
Join the Superbook DVD Club and get Superbook's newest episode, He Is Risen, plus 2 copies to share with others, all for your gift of $25.
They have arrested Jesus, the Messiah. Do you not know that I have the power to crucify you?
No! Please! You can't!
They've taken him to Golgotha. We must hurry.
Mary is about to lose her son. The worst thing any mother could face. I am not leaving her.
Superbook. It's an amazing way to build a strong spiritual foundation in the children you love.
Mary, who are you looking for?
I've seen him! He is alive!
Superbook. He is risen. Available now.
Natural disasters, massive traffic accidents, terrorist attacks. When disaster strikes, first responders have to be on the scene pretty quickly.
They have to work as a team, and they have to practice so they can be prepared. Chuck Holton takes us underground to show us how they train for emergencies.
Help us! Help!
A terrorist event in a crowded subway. Dead and wounded litter the station while rescuers rush in to help. Fortunately, this is only an exercise, but for the trainers in this scenario, it doesn't feel that way. First responders from around the nation travel here to the mountains of West Virginia to go underground.
We will take units from throughout the country, civil support teams, civilian first responders. We will tailor exercises to what their commanders need, whether it be a drug laboratory, a collapsed parking structure, a mock hostage rescue, to actual extraction from collapsed structures outside as well.
A tunnel that was once part of the state turnpike now serves a new purpose, taking disaster preparedness to a whole new level.
We can make it high noon, or we can make it midnight. We can have flame bars in here, we can have smoke. And the echo within the tunnel also adds to the realism too. You'll have jackhammers, you'll have sawing, you'll have people crying for help.
I did not go past the box to see if there's an operator. Go check.
Copy that.
Today's exercise, a simulated terror attack on a subway train. Local West Virginians serve as victims, and the training unit came all the way from Portland, Oregon.
This, a response like this in this type of a scenario, that's very rare. That's why we travel from Portland to West Virginia to do it. We train routinely, but you do not get a tunnel environment in which you can put a rail car and smoke and victims and control the environment like they've done here.
Our job was to come in and do a sweep of the scene and locate devices and render them safe or determine if we can work around them. First thing we're doing is trying to get those folks out of harm's way while our EOD guy renders them safe.
A major car pileup inside a tunnel like this would be a nightmare scenario that would see various different agencies all converging on the scene. And if they had never worked together before, they might not be able to respond effectively. That's why the training they do here at the Center for National Response is so important.
These are the guys that are going to respond. These are the people that are going to show up after the first responders are there and they ask for assistance. These are the people that are going to show up, and these are going to be the heavy lifters. They're the guys that bring the big equipment. They bring the personnel that's needed to do a very large event.
Emergency workers come from far and wide because this level of realism isn't available anywhere else.
This is the first time in a long time that we've actually had live actors. And I think the live actors provide a sense of realism and urgency. And we hope we never have to use this, but the more prepared we are, the better we are in case something happens.
The military gets to use the tunnel as well. Here, United States Marines conduct chemical and biological training in a simulated drug lab.
Special operations also come from around the country to train in this specially constructed cave complex, which is built to look just like the ones in Afghanistan. And it doesn't get much more realistic than this.
In the mountains outside Charleston, West Virginia, I'm Chuck Holton for CBN News.
Discretion is advised. Stay tuned for an appalling report on Sex Week at Yale and a warning that this could be coming to your child's university.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
So Sexually transmitted infections are on the rise every year in the United States, according to the Centers for Disease Control. The CDC's new estimates show that there are about 20 million new infections each year, and that costs the healthcare system nearly $16 billion just in direct medical expenses. Half of all the new infections occur among young men and women. The CDC says there are more than 110 million total sexually transmitted infections in the U.S.
Every year, thousands of high school students apply to America's top universities, hoping to get a world-class education. But that education isn't what it used to be. It now comes with some shocking extras. Lee Webb explains.
For a glimpse into America's future, look no further than its college campuses. American higher education is in moral and academic decline. So says Nathan Harden, a 2009 Yale graduate who's written Sex and God at Yale, Porn, Political Correctness, and a Good Education Gone Bad. Harden says Yale's highly publicized Sex Week is just one example of the moral crisis affecting American higher education. During Sex Week, porn stars and sex industry CEOs are invited on campus for a marathon of sex-related film screenings and seminars and product demonstrations, all sanctioned by the university as sex education. Other universities have followed suit and offer their own versions of Sex Week. Harden says this sex-saturated culture underscores the loss of purpose that permeates academia today. He points out that extreme agendas and single-minded political correctness have left us with universities that seem to no longer know what is or isn't worth teaching in their classrooms.
And for more about the sex industry's infiltration of colleges, CBN founder Pat Robertson spoke with author Nathan Harden. He asked Nathan who's behind the shocking events happening at Yale.
Officially, it's run by and organized by students, but the administration approves the use of Yale classrooms on an event-by-event basis. So a lot of the sponsorship, unfortunately, has come from the sex industry, whether it be porn companies, sex toy manufacturers, and so forth, have been funding these and basically turning the classroom at Yale into a marketing forum for pornography. So I saw, for example, live demonstrations of a topless porn star demonstrating her sadomasochistic techniques in a classroom, things that I thought I would never see.
This is a classroom at Yale?
These are classrooms where I studied Shakespeare, yep. Dante, international relations.
How many students were in these classes?
Well, hundreds.
Hundreds came to.
Yes, and there are some things that are so graphic I can't really talk about them on television. But needless to say, it involved everything from graphic demonstrations of oral sex to actual screening of hardcore violent pornography in the classroom. And this is at a university that claims that they are for women's rights. But I saw women openly demeaned and objectified through this violent porn. And I was outraged by it, and that's really what.
All right, you've got a porn star up in front of a class of a couple hundred students, 300, 400. How many were you?
Yes, there were more than 1,000 students.
1,000 students?
Mm-hmm.
And so she's talking about sadomasochism?
That's right. And that involves, you know, violence and in a sexual context. But to me, what was shocking was not so much the moral questions of what was going on themselves, but the fact of where it was being done.
Yeah.
This is being, anything that's going on in a Yale classroom is, whether the university administration wants to admit it or not, it's given a sort of a stamp of approval. They wouldn't allow the Ku Klux Klan to come in there and do a white supremacist demonstration. They wouldn't allow women to be, we wouldn't think, openly demeaned, but that's in fact what happens.
You know, you point out in your book that this extreme eroticism, or whatever you call it, was to show everybody that they had gotten all the way away from these original Christian roots. Is that what you were maintaining? Do you want to amplify that?
In a sense, I think Yale doesn't know what it stands for anymore, except for maybe its own sense of elitism. And I think that's really the crux of the problem. Whether you want to look at, you know, these sort of radical sexual agendas, the sort of loss of academic standards in the art department, Or another example I talk about in the book where they actually admitted a former diplomat at large for the Taliban during the time I was there. I ended up taking my final exam for international relations, seated next to a man who was a sworn enemy of the United States. Unfortunately, it goes well beyond Yale. I'm seeing these kind of activities. These sex weeks are now at Harvard, Brown, Duke, University of Illinois, Northwestern, University of Tennessee. Parents need to be aware of what's happening. They need to prepare their kids for the moral battleground that they're going to face in college.
Why would anybody want to send a kid to one of these places? I mean, well, what's to be gained?
I think, in some sense, we as Christians need to stand up and let the truth be heard, whether it's students who are at Yale or some other college. We need to expose the lies that are being told in these classrooms and these sort of elements. Otherwise, without the truth being told, it goes on in secret.
When you're driving along and your cell phone rings, do your eyes instantly go off the road? Then you need to get a grip. Hi, David Jones here with the new GripGo, the most versatile hands-free mount that will instantly grip any phone for safe driving. Just attach the suction cup to your windshield or dash, and GripGo grabs your phone ultra fast. Then it peels right off. And don't worry, there's no sticky residue left behind. The 360-degree pivoting mount allows you to always get the perfect viewing angle. It's even strong enough to grab and hold this expensive smartphone out the window, yet it comes right off with ease. That's the advantage of GripGo. You can get the amazing GripGo with dashboard mount for only $14.95. We'll send you a second kit free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Get two complete GripGo systems for just $14.95.
To order GripGo for $14.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-709-5259 or order online at getgripgo.com.
Jim is 38, mortgage, married, three great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. Jim can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $19 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll comparison shop the pick of insurance companies like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. Jim's wife, Deidre, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote. We shop, you save.
Finally today, you may spend a lot of time watching TV.
But a new study reported in the London Telegraph says people also spend a lot of time just looking for the remote control, more than 5 minutes a week. Now that adds up to 2 weeks and a day over the course of an average lifetime. The study found that one of the main reasons the remote gets lost is because children hide them. I could see that.
Children or your aging parent who lives with you. That's a problem in our house.
Get rid of that remote.
I can't find it. It's like, where'd it go?
I tell you.
Well, that's all for now on the CBN News Channel. You can find more of our exclusive coverage of the issues you care most about at cbnnews.com.
Tell us what you think about the stories you've seen here today on Facebook or at CBN News on Twitter. Bye-bye.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real, naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free, no obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 800-868-9957. That's 800-868-9957.
Introducing the CBN Bible from CBN.com. Now, an easier way to study the Bible and grow in your faith. Highlight your favorite verse. Read separate versions at a glance. Click and read a commentary. Or cross-reference your favorite verse using the Strong's Concordance. All the right tools to study the Bible, all in one place. The CBN Bible, available at cbn.com/Bible or the iTunes App Store.